29, 30, 812, 94.
Mechanical sieve shakers.
This is W.S. Tyler's Mechanical Rotap series, and it does exactly what it says. It rotates and it taps. And these oscillating and tapping motions are so precise and so consistent that they can be used in the most heavily regulated industries imaginable. They're all designed to get the particles placed in the top sieve and separate them through their specific sieves to their individual sizes. Oh, and it's also called a mechanical sieve shaker because of the motor that generates the oscillating motion. And the motor also runs the hammer, which forces the particles through the openings in the mesh. But each of these Rotap models is made slightly different to fit your specific particle size analysis needs. The RX-29 has basically been the industry standard since we invented it back in 1914. Now, it was updated and upgraded since then, but the idea is still the same. It creates a dual oscillating motion and uses a brute force hammer tap to separate particles into their individual sizes. The RX-29 uses 8-inch test sieves, and you can fit up to 6 full-height sieves plus a collection pan, or 13 half-height sieves plus a half-height collection pan. So the RX-30 is exactly the same as the RX-29, except it uses 12-inch test sieves. And you can only fit 4 full-height sieves with a full-height pan, but if you use a half-height pan, you can use 6 full-height sieves. But if everything's half-height, then you can fit 8 12-inch test sieves. Do you find yourself getting really annoyed by that noisy banging sound that comes with the tapping part of the Rotap? Well, if you're using 100 mesh sieves or coarser, then the RX-812 is the shaker for you. As you can see, no hammer. The oscillating motion is actually enough for the particles to find the openings, but particles finer than 100 mesh, you can't run them through the 812. The particles won't consistently find the openings without the brute force hammer tap. It's actually pretty quiet. So the 812 is actually designed to run 12-inch test sieves, but there is a very, very easy conversion kit that'll make it able to run 8-inch test sieves as well, so pretty good deal.
Look, I gotta level with you.
Just because you have coarse particles doesn't mean you can always use the 812. It really depends on your industry standards, and most standards do say you need the hammer tapping motion because it is more consistent. And now we arrive at the RX-94, dare I say, the coolest shaker of the series. Once again, it runs exactly like the RX-29, except dual stacks. Double the amount of particles to analyze, operation sliced in half. This is the way. And you can run 6 full-height sieves with a full-height pan, and 13 half-height sieves with a half-height pan. But, two things. If you're switching from a single sieve stack shaker to an RX-94, you should definitely run another end-of-sieving analysis. This is because the two stacks only use one hammer to distribute the power through both stacks. Oops. The second thing is that both sieve stacks have to use the same sieve sizes. You can't have full height sieves on one side and half height sieves on the other because both sieve stack covers are connected, so they have to be even. And the last thing I wanted to say was that all of our mechanical sieve shakers use the exact same interface. 29, 94, 812. And they can all run up to 99 minute operations with a tolerance level down to 0.1 seconds. Just set the time you want, press start, and you are now conducting particle size analysis W.S. Tyler style. And without getting too over the top, that's our Rotap Mechanical Sieve Shaker lineup. Now, this was just an introductory level video. Feel free to visit our Learning Center or our YouTube channel where you can learn everything you need to know about each one of these Rotaps and more. And if you have any questions at all, our Talk to Us button is only a click away. That'll get you in touch with our many experts. Seriously, whatever the question is, they can answer it. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you around in the next video. Bye for now.